we were at a point where we had to do a new facility, and just with labor becoming more challenging and, you know, trying to spend more time with the family, having a more flexible schedule, that was the biggest reason to go to robotics. And also for the cows, I think it's probably, for animal welfare, it's probably the best decision for the cows. We've been with DeLaval GNT Dairy Farmers for over 20 years now, so the service was great, and we really enjoyed that. When these 300s came out, the new cameras and just the attachment rate was so incredible that it was hard not to install these ones. The startup was great. We didn't need anybody in the robot rooms. We just had people pushing cows through, so it, you know, eliminated some labor, and it went. We were very surprised how quick the robot would attach to the udders. Like the first day in here, you know, it was a matter of minutes and the robot was attached. Yeah, basically the heifer comes in. More often than not, we don't have to manually attach. Heifers are usually quite calm, but it's definitely handy to have that manual attach. I couldn't think of robots without them, because it is nice when you do have a heifer that's being difficult to be able to have a second person there to keep her calm and then manually attach the udders. But I usually find by the second or third milking, they're quite comfortable. Once they're eating grain, they're quite calm. Yeah, I mean, overall, the cows have adjusted really well. I mean, some cows have taken longer to adjust than others, but overall, it's been a really smooth transition. Yeah, well, it's pretty handy how you could adjust the positioning on the indexing. So any bigger cows that we have, we just make the robot bigger for them. The majority of the cows fit pretty comfortably in the robot. We have about 50 cows per robot right now, between 50 and 55. I think that's a really good number. I know we could go higher, but I think for the number of milkers we want, I think that works pretty good. So we could get up to 60 cows per robot. That's how much room we have in this barn. Yeah, I think that's one of the selling points we was on the top there, was just not only it cleans it, it also dries it. So when that attachment comes on, the teat is nice and dry. It's not dripping wet. So that was huge for us. We really liked about the DeLavals is the fact that the vacuum pump is in the utility room and the hot water tanks are in the utility room. There's nothing in like that in the robot. So it's standard, you know, hot water tank. It's standard vacuum. It's nothing special to the robots. They use it in parlors, you know, and those hot water tanks are just industrial water tanks. They're not specialized tanks that go in robots. So we really like that too. It's just simple fix if anything has to get repaired. And I think the water is pretty efficient. I was a little bit worried about how much water the robots would use, but I think overall they've been really good. We have health reports that come out every day. We have the OCC counter on two of the robots, one on each side. So I look at that every day, check on high SMEC cell counts. Honestly, our SMEC cell counts are quite low in this new barn. So we really haven't had to call any cows because of SMEC cell counts yet. But it's definitely very handy because you can see cows have dropped in their milk or low activity. But it's been a really easy learning curve. There's lots of support in DeLaval to help me through the software. And the way DelPro is set up, you know, there's one screen that kind of gives you the breakdown of everything going on the farm, whether it's repro or, you know, cow flow, you know, milk production. It's pretty simple to kind of sift through that information and figure out what you need to actually look at. We don't have herd navigator right now. We just go strictly off activity, which has been fantastic. The DelPro activity has been great. Picks up every cow. Well, for us, it's service with our dealer, but also the attachment rate. It's incredible. And those couple other things I mentioned about just standard vacuum pumps and hot water and those kind of things that I thought were a lot more simple than some of the competitors that had those kind of things built in the robots. I just thought for maintenance and, you know, if you had to replace it, it'd be definitely more cost effective. Well, I like how the robot recaptures the teat placement after milking. So the teat spray actually gets on the teat. It doesn't miss, doesn't get on udders, it gets more on the teat. And you're paying money for the teat tip. You don't want it on the udder, you want it on the teat, right?